Max and Cheryl Wilson, and we live in Blacktown, Emails.
We have been in lockdown since the end of March and are slowly starting to get back to normal.
We miss you all at Autry and Desert Cree and hope to see you soon.
Keep safe and stay positive. Bye for now.
Hello everyone. I hope you're all keeping well through these tough times. And looking to send my well wishes from all of us at the Irwin household. Just out for a wee bit of a walk with my dog here. There she is there. She likes to poke through the hedges whenever we're out for a bit of a walk. I find that just being out for a bit of a walk clears the head. So, as I say, I hope everyone's keeping well. It is tough times we're going through, but hopefully we'll come out the other side and we'll be all put to be back to worshipping at Desert Great and Artray again as soon as. And as I'm a Cub Scout leader, it'll be good to see everyone back from the Cub Scouts and all. And even the wee ones are missing the likes of Sunday school and stuff too, and missing going to the likes of church to meet other people, because it is good to get out. So I say just a big shout from our family to your families, and I hope you all are keeping well.
Hi, my name's Lorraine Taylor and I live in New Mills, Dungannon. I've been in lockdown now since the end of March. I am church warden in Artray and am missing all my church friends. We are keeping in contact using WhatsApp, and it's been a godsend in these tough times. Hope you all keep well and safe.
We are missing so much during lockdown, but probably more than anything, you're just missing the company of other people. Thank you so much to our own troops this morning for popping up to say hello and pass on greetings. We appreciate you taking time to do it. The theme for this morning's thoughts is the theme of waiting, and our reading is from Psalm 130. And here's Nigel Irwin, one of our church wardens from Desert Crate, to do this morning's reading.
Good morning. Hope everybody is keeping safe and well. Today's reading is from Psalm 130, A Song for Ascents. Out of the depths I cry to you, Lord. Lord, hear my voice. Let your ears be attentive to my cry for mercy. If you, Lord, kept a record of sins, Lord, who could stand? But with you there is forgiveness, so that we can with reverence serve you. I wait for the Lord, my whole being waits, and in his word I put my hope. I wait for the Lord more than watchmen wait for the morning. Israel, put your hope in the Lord, for with the Lord is unfailing love, and with him is full redemption. He himself will redeem Israel from all their sins. Thanks be to God.
Well, hello and welcome back, and thank you for taking time to join us again today for our Sunday morning reflections. Today we start with some music. Over the years, we've been really privileged to have some superb musicians come and share their musical gifts with us at our Artray in Desert Crate. And of course, over the years, we've grown our own superb musical talent as well. At concerts, at cafe church, at seasonal festivals, music has always played a really important part. Now, during lockdown, lots of musicians have been busy linking up online, recording and writing and creating. In the past year, we've had Jonathan Ray at Caffey Church, Sylvia Burnside taking part in a remembrance concert at Desert Crate. Just last week, they joined up in their respective homes, Jonathan in Bangor, Sylvia just outside Ballymena, and they recorded a song that Jonathan wrote some years ago during a period of serious illness. It's a beautiful, meditative song, and we use it to start our Sunday thoughts today. Listen and enjoy. And I want to say thank you to Jonathan for permission to use the song.
Persistent. in showing you care. Why should I think that you've left me friendless when your love is endlessly given to me? Lord, there is nothing that you cannot do. Please give me faith to rely on you. Faithful, dependable, loving and true. You are God and you'll do what you've said you will do. Why should I fear the enemy's arrows when you feed the sparrows and know them by name? Why should I fret and worry in sorrow when you hold tomorrow? Lord, there is nothing that you cannot do. Please give me faith to rely on you. Faithful, dependable, loving and true. You are God and you'll do what you said you. Why should I fear that I'm not forgiven when you keep on giving the grace that I need? Why should I doubt the words you have spoken when you've never broken a promise to me? Lord, there is nothing that you cannot do. Please give me faith to rely on you. Faithful, dependable, loving and true. You are God and you'll do what you've said. You are God, and you'll do what you've said you will do.
Well, is anybody else more than just a little bit fed up now? The new normal isn't quite here, though the shops did open in Cookstown yesterday, and that was lovely to see. The shutters back up and the lights back on. And certainly this morning, Saturday morning, nice to see the market traders back in town. It's been certainly quite a long wait, and the new normal, as we call it, won't be here for quite a while yet. I was looking at our church YouTube channel, Desert Create Church, and realised that since lockdown, we've done 12 online Sunday morning thoughts, plus about another 10 videos of music or little features on church life and community life. Some people have been quite okay during lockdown. Certainly the introverts who charge their batteries by getting quiet time alone. Chances are that they are going to be supercharged at the end of all of this. Then the extroverts who get their energy from other people's energy, they're possibly flagging. And then there's the ambiverts. Yes, there really is such a thing. Not so sure how they're doing. You need to ask them. But hopefully we'll be able to meet in our church buildings again fairly soon for worship. On my desk, there's a 21-page document published by the Church of Ireland, and it contains all the protocols, rules, regulations, and suggestions for getting back to church. And we have a group meeting this coming Monday night to talk through all those practicalities of masks and bins and signing in and social distancing, etc., etc. But certainly, it has been a long wait. Just before lockdown, I started a project with our schools based on the Book of Psalms. If you're not familiar with the Psalms, it's an Old Testament book of songs and poems, many of them about 2,000 years old, some of them even older, about 3,000 years old. And as I've said before, I love to see the Psalms as being a bit like songs in the key of life. If the Bible is able to speak to us, somebody once said, the Psalms are able to speak for us. And that's quite a good way to think about what they are. And one of the things that fascinates me when I read thoughts and ideas from a long time ago is the fact that some things never change. Now, of course, lots of things do change, but some things don't. I saw a book sitting at home the other day and the title caught my eye. The author is one John Mark Comer, and the title of the book is The Ruthless Elimination of Hurry. I haven't read it yet, but I'm going to guess it's partly about slowing down, partly about learning to be still, and also partly about learning how to wait. Now, in many ways, lockdown has made life more difficult for all of us. Some of you have health worries, money worries. Isolation gets to you. Some of you have maybe lost your jobs. Possibly some of you have lost loved ones during the whole lockdown. Others are facing extra stresses or maybe increased mental health problems or anxiety. There are positives too, believe it or not. Life is a bit less rushed, a bit less hurried. And if we can learn to be patient and to wait, there may be good things to learn. Now, waiting is a common theme in the Book of Psalms. Psalm 40 has these words, I waited patiently for the Lord. He turned to me and heard my cry. Or Psalm 27, wait for the Lord, be strong and take heart. And of course, this morning's reading, Psalm 130. Waiting is part of life. We mostly don't like it because often life is too hurried. But we need to wait at the doctor's surgery. We need to wait in the dentist's waiting room. We need to wait at the level crossing when the sign above the button says, wait. We need to wait in the queue at the supermarket, now socially distanced, but still looking at the pile of groceries in the trolley of the lady in front and thinking, how long must I wait here? I had this bright idea yesterday. I decided I would make elderflower cordial. Quite a random thing, I know, but elderflowers grew outside my office window here at Desert Crate. So I lopped some off, got a few bags of sugar, some lemons and citric acid, put them in a pot with water, and then I had to wait. And we're going to see how it turns out. The problem is we're not very good at waiting, even though sometimes waiting can lead to worthwhile results. Back to today's reading from Psalm 130. It's a poem or a song about someone else's decision to trust God and to trust God's timing despite frustrations and hassles. Now, many of us have been living lives that are simply far too hurried, and we need to learn to wait. We need to eliminate hurry. We need to learn to be still. When I read the stories of Jesus from the Gospels, I am struck by the fact that he was often busy, but never hurried. And those are two different things. Jesus knew exactly how to pace himself. He knew when it was time to get away from the crowds. He knew the importance of slipping off alone by himself to a quiet garden when it was getting dark. He knew how to be still. He knew how to wait. And even on occasions when his disciples and friends were putting pressure on him and forcing him to do this and to do that, to go and see so-and-so, he never seemed to live in a hurried way. often busy, but never hurried. There's a huge difference. Being busy can be really good. It's good to have projects. It's good to have things to do. It's good to have a routine. Those things are good. But being hurried is rarely a good thing. Now, the writer of Psalm 130 mentions that he has been in trouble. He talks about speaking from the depths, which is an Old Testament way of saying he's in trouble. He's up against it. It could be illness. It could be enemies. It might be depression. It might be loneliness. It might be wrong choices that he's made. But at any rate, it hasn't turned out well. And he's calling out to God from the depths. Now, it was quite an Old Testament way of thinking that if life wasn't working out for you, then you must have done something really bad and God was punishing you. And I still hear people think like that and suggest things like that. And certainly over the past few months, I've heard it said on more than one occasion that God is punishing us through COVID-19. I think that's nonsense, by the way. The writer of Psalm 130 knew that if God was to keep a list of our failings, then literally none of us could stand. We would all be struck down. All have sinned. As Paul reminds us in the New Testament, everyone misses the mark despite our best efforts. Back to Psalm 130 then. The writer reflects that with his God there is forgiveness. With his God there is unfailing love. And with his God, there is full redemption. In other words, God is for us. Years ago, someone told me that God always answers prayers. Sometimes he says yes. Sometimes he says no. But often, he says wait. And that's why learning to wait on God and his timing is so, so important in our lives. Look, we're all in a time of waiting, whether you're a Christian or not. We're waiting for some kind of new normal, and hopefully we're moving in the right direction. But when life is a bit tricky, or indeed more than a bit tricky, it's good advice to learn to wait on God and trust that he knows what he's doing. Because when we're in his hands, we're in really good hands. I'm going to pray for us all now, and then we're going to hear another song based on Psalm 130. Over the years, the words of the psalm have been put to music by Bach, Mozart, Handel, Mendelssohn, and indeed many others. But we're finishing our time today with a new version of the psalm. I hope you enjoy it. The words will be on the screen. If you can pick up the tune, you can sing along. A prayer based on Psalm 130. We wait for the Lord. We wait with deep longing, and in his word we stand, waiting in hope. We hope in the Lord, for with the Lord there is steadfast love, and with the Lord there is great power to save, to rescue, to redeem. So let's go now with assurance, hope and promise, praying that the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ may rest upon us, that the love of God, the Creator and Giver of life, may embrace us, and that the transforming power of the Holy Spirit may uphold us this day and always. Amen.
that full forgiveness meets my gaze. I stand redeemed by grace alone. Courage in him.